I want to get you an extraordinary moment for space exploration now. An all-female crew will fly into space later this year featuring global superstar Katy Perry, TV personality Gayle King. The Blue Origin mission is being touted as the first all-woman spaceflight in more than 60 years. Well, Aisha Bowe is a superstar in her own right, a NASA rocket scientist, no less, entrepreneur, global advocate for STEM education, and she will be on this flight. And Aisha Bowe is with us here this evening. It's terrific to have you. Mabruk, as we would say from here, congratulations. I'm sure you're, this is a terrific opportunity. Tell us about this mission, if you will. Tell us some of the details of what will happen.
I'm absolutely thrilled to be on a trip to space with an incredible group of explorers. I mean, wow, yesterday was like watching my dreams come true. I never could have dreamed from my first day at NASA that I would be here talking with you about this trip.
So how did it happen? Come on.
Well, you know, I think that the first day when I was working at NASA, I had the opportunity of meeting some really interesting individuals who I've kept in contact with throughout the duration of my career. And as you know, I really did not have the opportunity to go to space when I was previously working at NASA because this company didn't even exist. Over the past decade, there have been a lot of advances in commercial spaceflight, and being able to be here on the cusp of something so extraordinary, with the ability to work with nonprofits and organizations to advance science, is just absolutely thrilling.
What do you think the nature, well, I mean, you must be, you know, not only absolutely thrilled to get on, but also, like you say, this group of incredible women. What do you believe that this all-female crew could accomplish within the realm of space exploration? Just explain sort of how unique this is and what you think the sort of opportunities are.
Not only is this a historic first, I can remember speaking to a woman who approached me and said, Aisha, my daughter wants to be an astronaut. And I had encouraged her to become a doctor. But seeing you, seeing this, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna buy her the astronaut costume. Because it's not a costume, it is the dress for what she wants to be in the future. You know, studies show that many times girls, if they don't see it, they won't think that they can achieve it. And early on, they pursue other fields. And so to see six women who are all incredibly unique, who are very inspiring in their own right, come together and globally on a campaign, I think what you're gonna see is not only more women, but more people know that they can too become one of us, and that they also can reach and work in these fields.
As a rocket scientist yourself, what do you hope to achieve?
Well, part of what I look to conduct on this mission is meaningful science. I'm working with universities and nonprofits in order to conduct research, and I hope to share the research as well as data on how I respond to spaceflight with the community so that people can better understand what happens when we fly to space.
Look, I mean, I'm just listening to you, and I feel so excited for you. Here's what one famous Blue Origin crew member had to say after his trip. Have a listen.
I hope I never recover from this.
I'm so excited.
I hope I never recover from this, says William Shatner. Good.
I'm so excited. I mean, the overview effect has been studied, and I can't wait to have the opportunity to look at the Earth from space where there's no boundaries, and I'll have a full appreciation for all of the things that people have worked over the last few decades to achieve. To be here, having been a community college student who once never knew what she wanted to do and didn't aspire to do anything more than to graduate and not have to live with my parents, I'm absolutely thrilled to have the opportunity to not only go to space, but to be surrounded by a phenomenal group of explorers, to conduct research, and to be able to bring what it is that I've learned up there back home.
I've got two little girls. You are an inspiration to me, and you will be an inspiration to them. And I feel very privileged to have you on this show this evening. Good luck. Come back and tell us all about it.